I understand that, but I only spun out one time during the whole race, and I got sent off into the woods twice. And I came back in, I went to the back. But listen to him, I bumped into him, and I knew I did it, and I went right up to him afterwards, did I or did I not? And I walked up to him, and I said, I apologize, I caused the mistake. And he said, don't worry about it. Because, ask Joe, where's Joe? Joe even said, he said, no, you're keeping your lines, you're doing good. Eric was behind me. Eric says, you're keeping your lines, you're doing good. I wasn't trying to cause anybody. I spun out one time by myself back here, and I admitted that. But that's what I'm saying. You pay money to want to come out here and race, and then everybody gets pissed off at the rookies because why? You guys have been out here for 17 years. So you got guys that are up in the front who what have been up in the front every week. Look at the cars. Which I understand that, but that's what I'm saying. You look at the difference. You know they put time into their cars, they put the money into their cars. They love this stuff, and I agree with that. And I understand that, and I know he does. He does a great job, and I'm not trying to bitch about that. What I'm saying is we're trying to be fair out here with everybody. Brian, myself and Brian bumped into each other a couple different times, and I gave him the thumbs up. Hey, man, I apologize. You know? What's your name? Melissa. I bumped into Melissa coming into the turn, and I backed off and gave her the right of way because why? She's been out here long. She knows where her line is. I'm in a new car that I don't know the line. So I'm getting singled out and screamed and yelled at for what? Because I spun out one time. That was my point. I spun out one time.
Right, the back is right now.
But
you're getting there. Yeah, definitely getting there.
But here's the thing. It wasn't all the new guys who were spinning. They weren't all the new guys. Your brother, Brian, spun out. Eric caused three different cautions. Billy caused two cautions. And the rookie guys weren't doing anything. That's what I'm saying.
That's
so why are you sitting and pushing the rookies out when they weren't even the ones causing any of the cautions? That was my point. We weren't causing any of the cautions. I went off into the woods the one time. Nobody threw a caution out until I came back up to get on the track.
Just bury out.
And now here's the question I have for you. You saw
it went way off.
None of the lights were on until I stood back up at the corner because I was looking for it. Because believe me, listen to me. I'm not going to fight the issue. Whatever. Then answer me this. You worry about guys going off into the woods, then why is nobody not? The caution should be shot out and someone should be checking on a guy that goes off into the woods. Not a single person came down to me. Both times I went into the woods, nobody came down until I was already on the track. That's my point. You want to go ahead and sit there and run things and be safe about it? Then when a guy goes off at either end, I'm sorry, shut it down, throw out the red flag and say, wait until we find out what's going on with the guy in the end. It's plain and simple.
We don't have enough because volunteers. We don't have enough.
You got one guy right here with a red flag. He throws out a red flag, you see someone go off there, throw the red flag and stop everybody and check and see who's down off in the woods. Because for all you know, someone could be flipped over.
We usually have no one go into the woods.
You can't help it when someone hits your rear end.
Well, we had a lot of that today.
Exactly, that's my point. If I wasn't keeping my lines, I would have never made it up to fourth place. Would I or would I have not? Which means everybody else was wrecking, and you're pinpointing it on the rookies. I'll be honest with you. You know what? This is nothing. I used to race motorcycles. This is nothing for me. I know how to keep lines. I know how to go ahead and race and drift around a corner. That's not an issue.
Drifting is a problem.
Every one of these cars, dude, don't play no bullshit with me and act me like this is my fucking first night out on the earth.
Hey,
because every one of these cars, the back ends kick out and drift.
Yeah.
You know what? Then don't invite people out there and show favoritism. That's the problem.
There's no favoritism.
You were! You just kicked the rookies off the damn track!
Guys,
there was one caution as soon as we walked off the fucking track! Regardless!
We have all those cautions.
Then tell the guys that have been wrecking because Eric spun his car three times, your brother caused two cautions, Billy caused two cautions, I caused one caution when I spun, and the other one I got pushed off in the woods. So don't sit there and single out any fucking rookie, because it's bullshit. So you know what? Guess what? You won't have to worry about it, because I won't come back out here.
You're nice.
It's plain and simple.
Leave right now.
Because you guys are a bunch of fucking retards.
Yes, get the fuck out of here right now before we call the fucking cops.
Whatever.
The fuck? Shut up. I've never, 20 years we've been doing this, never had any dollars right here.
Well, you know what? I'm sorry, because no one else had balls enough to stand up.
Yeah,
and I'm not, and I did.
I'm sorry.
So deal with it.
You're like crazy, like
deal with it.
Oh, yeah, it fell off.
He started drifting behind Melissa.